hit that. Ready for this. Aye. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Aye. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Aye. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe, with a cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only when it gets exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only when it gets exception on my cool, yeah. Ain't no dub, ain't no L. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this, ayy. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this, ayy. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'ma act a fool with this, okay. Yeah, yeah. Can I hit that?
Folks in the Circle City, they love their Colts, and they have packed the house tonight as we welcome you to Lucas Oil Stadium in downtown Indianapolis. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Washington football team and the Indianapolis Colts. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. For the first time with Raheem Mostert. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points score, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. They'll let it go deep for Beckham. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. And they'll try to run the option here. Breaks through the contact. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 24 yards to gain there. Another first down as well. And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that. And here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this. But sometimes when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game. And all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
On first and 10, it's Mostert. And he is going to lose yardage here. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And this one incomplete. But too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
The gun now on third down. Strong coverage by Washington. And now fourth down.
There is some
to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep. Try and throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
Rodrigo Blankenship for the Colts field goal. A 32-yard attempt.
Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. And the Colts pick it up.
Just call it as it is.
But definitely not your own red zone.
In your own red zone, it's heightened, isn't it? Because you're almost automatically giving up a score and the momentum, and everything just changes for your team.
Yeah, so the kickoff fumble now, great field position. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. This is Mostert, and he'll fight his way down right around the 12. The safety, Landon Collins, there to make the tackle.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play. Trying to get it to Beckham, and it's intercepted. Picked by Kendall Fuller, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. On the ground with Bryce Love, the former Stanford Cardinal. And now where are they going to mark him here? Well, they say he did get back to the 1 yard line, but that could have easily been 2 points the other way.
And 10 at the 1 yard line.
Second and 10. Haskins from his own end zone. And he's not going to get away. The rush rush was too strong, and this is going to wind up a safety. So troubles here offensively. I tell you, the noise in this dome, that has got to make it harder for these guys to hear.
Sometimes I find myself shouting up here. But you're right. If you can't communicate well or get off the snap count properly, it can cause big problems, and this qualifies as a big problem.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Now this time he'll look to throw. Catch made here by Campbell. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards there, first down. He missed on his first three passes, was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection, maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you're wondering, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. I think he might be off to the races.
He was looking for Raheem Mostert there, but it'll be second down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Complete downfield on the left side. And all the way down to the 22-yard line. A big play there for Indy. 43 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. From the gun, a run with Mostert. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently,
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked by Kendall Fuller. And the goal return here as he takes it up past the 30-yard line. And now he already has two interceptions.
Yeah, he's got to guard against being tentative from this point forward, though. He's got to still make the right reads, make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw four interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand, put it behind you, keep pressing forward.
And he'll be tackled at about the 35. Give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Here's Haskins, a quick throw out wide, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down. Was that a design pass, or what was that?
It was built into the play call. He had the opportunity to either hand it inside, keep it himself to run it, or do what he just did. Throw that pass inside, hitting a receiver on the run.
On first down, here's Love. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady game.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. On the carry, it's Love. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 11 yards there, first down. Interior of that line blocked really well on that run, but also the two tight ends, they blocked well too.
Not only are they scouted the line of scrimmage, with their agility, they can get upfield and hit moving targets like linebackers, defensive backs. They do a really good job helping out the running game.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. This is Love. Again, he finds an opening. And finally taken down at the four-yard line. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards.
First and goal at the four-yard
line. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports.
With the score, Colts 5, Washington nothing.
One forward as they stop it right around the one. Give him four on the carry there. It's second and goal.
Brings up second and goal.
Second and goal from the one. Gonna give it to Love. And he is not gonna get in as the big body stop him at the one. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden, it's third and goal at the one. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. On the carry, it's Bunn, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. Nick Bonham, his third touchdown now on the year. And Washington has taken the lead. And that's why you have the fullback, Charles. Couldn't get it in the play before with the smaller guy. Turned to a little more power. They score it.
And that has to warm the hearts of a lot of old-school football fans. They love when they get to see a little bit of power football.
Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is now two. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Colts take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coach is insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. For the third time here this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line.
Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now after the turnover, here's Haskins. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. Well, as a lineman, they are trained. You've got to stay close to home. If you're more than a yard downfield, they're going to toss that flag, and they did there. Right, Here's Haskins out of the gun. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Walker. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. It's almost like you can see the look of frustration on his face. Four interceptions last week. We talked about it all week. What did he do wrong? And another one here in the first half.
And you can understand the frustration. You actually feel his pain a little bit. But the worst thing he can do is what you're seeing right now, showing the other team that he's frustrated. All they're going to do is double their efforts to make him even more frustrated. He's got to gather himself, compose himself, and keep fighting.
Well, he talked a lot about erasing that loss last week, getting back in the win column. We'll see how he responds. Second down at 6 now from the 42. They run the option on second down. A quick throw out to Adams on the perimeter. It'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Quickly into the hands of Baker. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Here's Mostert. Touchdown. Raheem Mostert, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Colts are going to jump back in front. I thought as that was developing that he might actually keep it, but the right decision, obviously, to hand the football off.
And some teams do a really nice job of taking a little bit longer at the mesh point, meaning where he's going to hand it off or keep it. Sometimes they ride it maybe a step longer than others. That allows him to make the proper decision and have the right person end up with the ball.
And it paid off with a long touchdown run.
At their own 25-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. As we know, they had the chance last week, Charles, to lock up the division. Couldn't do it. Now it all comes down to the final week of the season. But once again, they control their destiny.
And that's a good thing. But I wonder about mindset, because you mentioned they had a chance to lock it up last week, didn't. Are they bringing extra pressure to themselves now? Even though they control their own destiny with a win, now because they didn't get it done before, will they be even tighter as they approach this game?
And right now fighting for every win possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. To throw again. Haskins is going to find his running back. It's complete. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. So they went 2 yards in the wrong direction on the last pass play, and now it's third and 12. From the gun, it's Haskins. And he's got his man on the out route. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Give them 22 there on the third down conversion.
First down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
They go play action with Haskins. He's going to air one. That is incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And the ball comes out. Love lost it. And the Colts pick it up. There are
two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in the meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you've got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
So they need to determine if that knee was down before the ball was coughed up.
And they also wanted to make sure that the ball was possessed as they were going through, that the ball wasn't working its way free before the knee hit the ground.
Out there, set, ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
You always hear about empty possessions. Some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Throwing now, Haskins on first down. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 23. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. But we know he's an electric runner. Earlier this half, you were wondering how they were going to bottle him up at different levels. That was your suggestion. Some mixed results.
Yeah, certainly, because we have seen him bottled up at times. We've seen him play him very well. We've also seen him pop the cork a few times and get out of there, haven't we?
We have indeed.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. Digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Colts add on to their lead. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead.
Makes the score Colts 19, Washington 7. Rigoberto Sanchez.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. Willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
25-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And a first half that really has not been kind to them. A late opportunity here to maybe make some inroads on this deficit before half.
And this drive's going to go a long way towards telling us whether they actually have a chance to come all the way back in this game or not.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven, past the 30 to the 32. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
It's a gain of seven. Brings up second and three at the 32-yard line.
Out of the shotgun, Haskins. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Well, sometimes those cliches really come true, don't they? When they talk about it takes all 11 to play good defense. We've seen that in this ball game. I think the secondary has to be singled out, though. They are in the presence of every receiver whenever the ball's thrown. And this one, they have forced another incompletion.
He's going to be stopped short of a first down as they get to him at about the 33. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as they'll stop him with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. It's taken to the 26. Turn, and the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down, and it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before.
And the Washington pressure gets to him, and he will go down. Off the edge, the sack by Matt Ioannidis.
Brought down back at the 21.
Now the Colts will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by Troy Apke. Stages of the first half.
Intercepted by Washington. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 48-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Well, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. So we've come upon halftime here in week 17 as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the final two quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of week 17 is underway. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Haskins and the Washington offense going to come up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll drop the throw, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
But these guys are going to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Looking to throw, Haskins. And he'll find Hall. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
And the Washington first down.
They'll run on first down. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. A quick throw complete into the flat out left. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Brings up second and 7.
Operating from the gun, Haskins, and he slings one that's incomplete. He was trying to get that to Bryce Love out of the backfield, and it's third down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Third down, here's Haskins.
And he comes back with one complete. And he'll be touched out here, but not before he does pick up the first. Got what they needed there. The drive continues with a 9-yard pickup. On first down, it's Love. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Here's Love again. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Now 3rd down is looming. A pickup of 2 on 1st down and just 1 yard there.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. To throw on 3rd down. Haskins throwing middle, and it's complete. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
Washington 1st down.
They'll run on 1st down. Well, and just a couple yards there down to the 17.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Staying on the ground, it's Love. And he's going to get forward for about 5, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee? So that one will be accepted. Now they face a 2nd and long following the holding penalty. Quickly completed to the right flat. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on 3rd.
3rd down.
Set up 1st and goal.
At the 6-yard line.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. On 1st and goal. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky.
Brings up 2nd and goal at the 8-yard line.
Their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on 2nd and goal. 2nd down and goal. Haskins. And this is taken in for a Washington touchdown.
Complete.
From 8 yards out. And Washington has made this a 1-score game.
And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever, there it results in a touchdown. And this is back to a five-point game.
He is good. Makes the score Colts 19, Washington 14.
A five-point game now as here comes the kickoff. Takes this about 5 yards deep, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt a return.
25-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brings up second and 12 at the 23-yard line.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Now a shotgun snap as they look to throw. Caught on the right side by Adams. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down.
Down at the 49-yard line.
They run out of the shotgun with Mostert. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Washington territory. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
A gain of two. Brings up second and eight.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Yards to go on second down. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 16 yards, a first down. Probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing this fourth quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort, the catch, the extra yardage, but you've got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. A quick throw complete out to Beckham. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Campbell making the catch. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. I think you'd have to say defensively, these guys are doing their job pretty well, right?
Yeah, we talked about them holding them under 20 points, right, on defense. And they've done that. They've held them. The problem is their own offense hasn't answered their challenge, which was to score more.
Yeah, exactly. I remember you saying magic number was right around 20, and the offense has been the issue. You're right. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
10 at the 13-yard line.
And they'll go backwards. yards here, losing yardage to the 14. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
This one is down he goes. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Complete right around the 8. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on 4th and 1. They'll try it now with Mostert. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And that will force a turnover on downs. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. The interception sets them up with an opportunity to erase this fourth quarter deficit. And this series could very well determine our outcome. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up.
2nd and 10 at the 3-yard line.
Across the 10 to the 15. 12 yards there and a first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Throwing again. Haskins. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the play.
And that's precisely what allowed that defense to disrupt the pass. An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Third down, Haskins. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's 4th down.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Try and throw forward with Haskins. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker. Well, when you start thinking of guys that are in the mix for Defensive Player of the Year, I think you use him as Exhibit A. Maybe he's not the leading guy right now, but he's at least on the periphery and deserves to be in the discussion.
And because of that,
He's looking at a game today where, in order to make that big move and maybe become the guy, he needs multiple takeaways, multiple big plays, things that get our attention and reverberate for weeks to come.
And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Complete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
So much about defending the pass is being able to be right there at the moment the ball gets to the receiver, and he was right in his hip pocket, helping force that incompletion.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There's pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt.
First and 10 at their own 11-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. He's going to go up top again. Pressure there as it's intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
At their own 49-yard line.
Good starting field position for the Colts as they have it first and 10. Just shy of midfield at the 49. On the ground, it's Mostert to start the drive. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
This is 3rd and 2, maybe the biggest play in this football game. 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. They'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he's got it all the way down to the 12-yard line. That good for 22. First down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Now Mostert. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Mostert.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
9 yard line. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
This is Mostert, and he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you got to feel good about your chances.
Roberto Sanchez to kick off for Indianapolis.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
25-yard line.
They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And if I would kept having a rough patch, he said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here.
Second and 10.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw again. Haskins, he's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Intercepted. The Colts take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here.
Tonight's final score.
So this one winds up an Indianapolis victory. And you've got to say, CD, it was the defense who had a big part in the W.
Not without question. When you force four turnovers, you get to enjoy the spoils of victory, don't you? It's rare that you force four turnovers and lose a ball game. That's almost unheard of. They carried this one home. You talk about celebrating with each other and being in a position where going forward, all you think about is, let's get five next time. They're going to be on the hunt.
So for the Colts, it's an 11th win of the year as they'll finish the regular season at 11-5. And now they'll await the final seeding for the Colts.